just the real good-looking gay men, nothing else.
See, that's not goofy. That's sleazy. That's scandalous.
Aiken could go once a day for about an hour. She wants it three times a day.
Aiming for excellence and just missing the mark. This is Talk Soup. Greg Kinnear back with you one more time. Are we doing this again? My gosh, we're going to do it one more time. We've lined up all of the most outrageous, unforgettable, memorable moments of the daytime talk shows, strung them together in a half-hour show that just might knock your socks off today. Is that safe to say? No, it's really not. Nonetheless, coming up a little bit later on, you're going to be a teenage girl who falls in love with a convict. Grown woman is getting engaged to a serial killer. You'll meet here and hear her story. Plus, we invite you to get intimate with Ron, the amazing perforated man. Oh, well, thank you. Okay. First, Joe says his girlfriend Lisa is a sexual Olympian. Her appetite for her love is so voracious. It is so voracious. She has been known to take action anywhere and everywhere the mood strikes her. If you don't believe me, and quite frankly, why should you? Check out this clip from the Ricky Lake Show.
She's come to work, to pick me up from work in my car, and she didn't have anything on. Not a stitch of clothing. I was driving home, and her head is in my lap, and okay, I thought, okay, when I met
Johnny's
her...
Johnny's probably so envious right now.
When I met her, I thought I was the man, because I could go once a day for about an hour. She wants it three times a day, 45 minutes a clip. Okay? I've come home from work, and I have to, like, sneak in the house, and she jumps from behind the refrigerator with tools, and I've had a blanket thrown over my head, and she jumped to me right on the kitchen floor.
Oh, that's Lisa and Joe there on the Ricky Lake Show, recounting stories of jumping on the kitchen floor. Actually, our own John Esposito gets jumped by the crew members here sometimes at E, and I don't really ever think of it as, I guess, too strange. It's just something that happens, and they all get together and break out some microwavable popcorn, and John gets down on all fours, and ow. This Friday, Ricky will explore the issue of harassment. Tune in and find out what to do if your ex-love is making your life a living hell. Well, normally I don't make judgment calls, but I think it's safe to say that these next two women you're about to meet right here have lousy taste, very lousy taste in men. Even Christine are their names. They say their ideal man, the man of their dreams, the man that they have so much feeling for, it can't even be described in words. There's a gentleman by the name of Richard Ramirez, the Night Stalker Killer. They've each been pen pals with Ramirez since he's been in prison, and as this clip from the Sally Jesse Raphael Show reveals, they're also, as it turns out, a bit jealous of each other, as you'll see.
The first time I met him, his attorneys were there, and they told me that he was innocent, and they told me to keep visiting him, that it was good for him, and that's what they were telling me, so that's why, mainly why I went near someone like him, because I came from another state, and I didn't know even what happened. I didn't even know why he was there, and I didn't even find out until a year later what even happened. And that story that she just said, I've never heard anything like that, and I've read all the reports, but that's what
happened.
He deserves to get something like that from you for even writing back to you. So
what do you mean?
But you
no, I found the truth.
Ladies, I know the admiration has gone to the point of...
No, I wasn't there when he killed people.
And I'm surprised he even wrote back to you.
How do you feel about...
Well, he's still writing.
Are you going to marry him?
Yeah, we're supposed to get married.
Are you in love with him?
I don't know.
Maybe I should tell you some of the things
know?
He told me about you.
Why are you going to marry somebody you're not in love with?
Because she gets to go on talk shows.
Well, we had to stop the tape, as you probably saw.
I saw that. I saw it. Eva, having just about split Christine's head open with her backhand, proceeded to get into a nasty altercation with her, where both women had to be dragged off stage and discontinue their appearance on the Sally Jesse Raphael Show. And I hate to do this, but one more time in slow motion. As you can see, Eva, sitting here rather casually, suddenly rears back. The batter's not ready. Oh, there you have it. On Friday's show, Sally will introduce her guest to long-lost loved ones. Surprise reunions. Surprise reunions. That's what we've decided to call it. Well, according to the Reverend Bernie Saunders, this next guest from the Richard Bay Show is just plain skankish, or skank-esque, if you prefer. Anyway, her name is Anne Marie, and she likes to go bar hopping, just wearing nothing but underwear, and let guys drink shots of tequila off her. In fact, let's check. Skank factor of... 4. She insists she's not skankish. However, well, take a look at this.
When I go somewhere, if I go with, like, if I'm dating a guy, I go over his house, I do dress conservative. But when I choose and I go out...
Wait a second, appearing naked for the pizza pie delivery boy?
But that's like different. That's like goofy stuff. But I have a lot, I have more respect for myself than probably anybody you'll ever meet.
But you need to understand, the things that you say is goofy, that's not goofy. That's sleazy. That's scandalous. That's skankish. It's not goofy. I'm sorry?
My father did work in Woodstock, and I do not. I can't sleep around because of the way age is. So I express myself in the way I dress.
Having
but
men
that doesn't
drink
mean
shots.
I don't have men treat me disrespectfully. I'll walk away from them, okay?
If you think that men are respecting you, you looking like the Texas Howdy Do clown, I'm sorry.
Yes. So be it. But you know what?
Linda, if you're dressing for yourself, please, in the name of God, dress for all of us.
Highlight of nice clap, boys. Of Richard Bay there. I believe later on they pulled out an actual dictionary and defined skankish. Skankish, apparently noun, to skank, to have qualities of being a skank. See figure 3, and sure enough, there she is now. Friday on Richard's show. Cover up that cleavage or you're out the door. Moms square off with their daughters Friday. We'll take a quick break. I think it's a good time. And meet 3 women who claim they were fired for being straight. Plus, Vicki Lawrence tortures potential cow hosts. Next.
Don't move. You'll kill you.
Isn't this fun? Now, tarantulas are all poisonous, are they not?
Yes, they are.
Yeah, okay. Just clarifying that.
Becoming a Vicki Lawrence co-host makes Marine Boot Camp look like a walk in the park. Tuesday, Vicki made contenders pass a variety of strenuous, complicated tests. One of the most grueling was probably the notorious bug handling exercise. Professional insect wrangler Jewel Sylvester was on hand to assist the ladies in this activity. Take a look at this.
You can have him stay. Sit.
Thank you. What do I say?
Don't move. He'll kill you.
Isn't this fun? Now, tarantulas are all poisonous, are they not?
Yes, they are.
Yeah, okay. Just clarifying that.
This is the crazy Madagascar cockroach. These are yours.
What, do you not like cockroaches?
It's okay, dear.
Better angle.
We can't. Okay, let's go for... You want to try the deadly scorpion?
I guess not.
You're
the one of them. If you're going to be a co-host.
You like beetles?
Yeah. Mert, you're sort of handling.
How about a couple of little beetles? There we are.
There you go.
I guess not beetles. Okay.
Don't drop them. You'll hurt them. You'll break them.
Okay, let's go for...
Look, you frightened them.
You want to try for maggots, mealworms?
There you go. No, I can't.
Okay,
can't.
Let's try...
Mert, you're not
the old melon, Pete. There you go. Do you want to try one of those?
No.
Okay, well, just watch.
You're flunking.
I know.
Now, you want to handle something here. How about a little tarantula? We could put tarantula on her shoulder.
I'll share.
Okay, just stand really still.
Now, you want to tell these gals some of the movies?
I'll put him right here. Do not freak out.
There you go.
You're doing a great job.
There you have it. Highlight of Vicky there looking for a co-host for her show that actually will probably air today because this is from yesterday. And now, unfortunately, sadly for you at home, a look at the talent portion of the program. On this Friday, don't fear, Vicky's going to be giving out biker chick makeovers. You can bet. Whoa! You, hey, what? Get, hey! Hey, get! Well, you can bet ladies young and old are already lining up around the block, right? Well, these next guests from the Montel Williams Show say they were fired from their jobs for being, kind of a twist on things, fired from their jobs for being heterosexual. Here are apparently some facts. A, they were cocktail waitresses. B, the bar they worked at was turned into a gay establishment. And C, they were all allegedly canned for being straight. Time to hear some dissenting views on the case. Take a look at this.
When you go to a gay bar, what do you want to see when you get there? Do you want to see women waiting?
I want to see real good-looking gay men, nothing else. That's what I want to see. Montel, come on. When you go to buy a Cadillac, you don't want to see Oldsmobiles, right? No matter how big the headlights are, right? Look, a woman goes to Chippendales, she wants to see good-looking, well-built, straight men. And that's the way it is across the board. This guy wants to run a gay bar, he should run a gay bar. Now, these women's charges of discrimination, come on, haven't gay men and lesbians been discriminated against since time began? Guy wants to run a gay bar. Run a gay bar. You know? These women's attitude is real bad. I wouldn't buy a drink from anyone.
So you're saying it's okay
that you were discriminated against at the time.
What they did to us.
Wait, go ahead. I can't hear both of you at the same time. Why don't you ask your question? Go ahead.
So it's okay that we were discriminated against. I'm sure you've had discrimination towards you, right? That's what you just said.
The problem was your attitude to gay people.
That's not true. Discrimination against gay men does not make it right for them to discriminate
against women if they are in fact doing that. Mm-hmm. But I think in this case, being a male is a legitimate qualification for the job.
Highlight of the Montel Williams Show, all of the ex-waitresses are single moms. They have a lawsuit pending against the owners of the bar. Friday, Montel will be rubbing elbows and bumping biceps with some female bikers. In the words of the boss, come on, wrap your legs around these velvet rims and strap your hands across my engines. Friday. Heather's current boyfriend isn't the type of guy you take home to meet mom. I mean, first of all, he has to make parole. Even then, Heather's mom isn't likely to approve of the relationship. As Bertice Berry discovered, Heather has dated several convicts, and mom says it's about time. You listening? Yeah. Mom says it's about time that she grow up and develop better taste in men. What do you think?
Is this something that you saw in a movie? Something that...
He's very cute. He's understanding and he's respectful to me.
How old are you?
16.
Mom, how long has this been going on, Mom? How long has it been going on?
Probably since she was 13 is when she really started being attracted to boys who were in trouble. I don't know if they were in and out of jail or juvenile hall, but they, like she said, they're gangsters. They're hoodlums. They're guys who she says respects her. How can they respect her?
They're not hoodlums. I mean, she knows a lot of them. They come to the house. They're very respectful to her. She sits down. She
knows a lot of moms dating, by the way, the sheriff, right? I tell you. It's like one-stop shopping.
I've been saying that for years, my friends. Bertice Berry there with the highlight. You know, it must be love here because Heather has actually tattooed her boyfriend's scooter's name on her arm. Hey! That just happened recently, so that's big news. On this Friday show, Bertice hears from couples who are married for better or worse, for richer or poorer, but not for smarter or stupider, when your spouse turns out to be a real bonehead Friday. We'll take a break and be back with a very confused man who says maybe to save sex and find out why Letterman almost stayed with NBC after this. Educating an entire nation as to just how much trouble we're actually in. This is Talk Soup. We're back now. Why are so many teenagers contracting the HIV virus? That was the question being asked Tuesday on the Jerry Springer Show. Jerry also wanted to know what kids can do to keep from getting the AIDS virus. If this next man you're about to meet is any suggestion about what the voice of a younger generation is thinking, we could be in some very, very serious trouble. Take a look at this.
You're right. But listen, doctor, honestly, as good as you are, I could put you in a room with our first guest, and I could put you in a room there for 7 straight days, and I would bet this year's salary that you could talk to him for a solid week and not get him to give up sex.
Right.
Jerry, that's true.
Who are you
recommending?
Or with a condom. Okay, in other words, the message isn't going to work, and if the message isn't going to work on some kids, it doesn't work. Well, look. Then the question is, do you think it's better to use a condom or not? Is it better to use a condom or not? It's better to use without a condom?
You lie by principle. You have to live by principle. You don't live by...
I understand.
People isn't going to listen like that.
I know you have to live your life by principle, but yes or no? If, after all your attempts at principle, all your attempts at values, please, if the child is still going to go ahead and have sex, if after all your efforts, my question is it better to use a condom or not?
Now,
is it better to use a condom or not?
Answer, maybe.
You won't answer.
It is not,
maybe.
The highlight of Jerry Springer there on his show Friday. It's part 2 of the Teenage Runaway series. This time around, Jerry will meet with an audience full of guests. Come on. That's right, Teenage Runaways. Everybody knows about David Letterman's much-publicized switch to CBS, but did you know that the move was apparently almost deep-sixed by a counteroffer from NBC? At the last moment, apparently, according to a new book, Dave's original network came to him with a deal that he very, very nearly accepted. How do I know this? Because I watched this highlight from Good Morning America featuring author Bill Carter. Take a look at this.
There was, in fact, a last-minute offer made to Letterman, and he had a hard time making up his mind, and he called Johnny Carson.
Well, that's kind of the thing that really, one of the things that really surprised me is that Dave, I didn't know Dave wanted the Tonight Show as badly as he did. It was the dream of his life, and so when it came around again that NBC was making him an offer, even though it was a convoluted offer and he would have had to wait 18 months to get the Tonight Show, he wanted to take it because it was so important to him. It meant so much in his life. And all the people around him, including his agent, Mike Ovitz, were telling him, it's not a good offer. CBS's offer is better. And they didn't know how they were going to persuade him. And his executive producer, Peter LaSalle, who's very close to Dave, did contact Johnny. And Johnny was willing to talk to Dave. And when Dave called Johnny, Johnny said to him, you know, if I'd been treated the way you had been treated, I'd go out the door. And that was the last decision-making factor for Letterman jumping to CBS.
Highlight of GMA, Bill Carter is a New York Times reporter, has written the book about the late night wars. It is titled The Late Shift. Friday and Good Morning America, actor-director Albert Brooks. There he is. He's talking about his role in the James L. Brooks comedy that's supposed to be quite good, called I'll Do Anything. One more highlight ahead. It is the eye-watering art of, oh no, body piercing next. We're back. Still Talk Soup. One last clip for you. Hey, have you heard the news?
Bum, bum, bum.
Oh, they're good. They're very good. I'm going to be doing a little crazy, wacky, zany, shall I say, nutty late night show over at NBC called Later. As it turns out, it's on much later. But if you're out here in Southern California, beginning the 28th of this month, Monday through Thursday, we do a live audience thing, over 750,000 studio audience members. If you'd like tickets, simply write NBC Tickets, 3000 West Alameda, Burbank, California, 91523, or call 818-840-3537. Yeah, that's kind of fun. Hey, you're about to meet Ron Athey. His body's a living, breathing, occasionally squealing work of art. I don't know how else to set this man up other than to just say, hey, look.
I come out as a nurse, a female nurse.
Mm-hmm.
I do piercing, branding, enemas, cutting.
Or of others.
Others, and I have it done to myself.
Mm-hmm.
Some
branding?
Have seen... Pardon?
Branding,
yeah. And
wow.
That
must hurt.
Sometimes I follow the story, you know, stories of the lives of saints. Like in One Piece, I end up as Saint Sebastian at the end, which is the saint that was martyred with arrows in his body. Mm-hmm. But I do it with long spinal needles.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And there's something about needles up into your forehead or something?
Right, crown of thorns. I have a Christ obsession.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And now, you know where to do it so that it doesn't leave huge scars when you don't want to leave scars, right?
But no, I use new needles and they don't stay in.
Oh.
There's no secret entry point.
How big are the needles?
Different sizes.
Yeah.
You know, certainly not as big as a knitting needle.
Well, good.
Not as small as an acupuncture needle. They can be pretty big.
Right, right. And you also have some piercing right now. You have this.
Right.
Yeah,
labret. And
you've got
half inch.
Now, those are big.
Nipple. Yeah, I've been doing them for, I don't know,
see, yeah.
10 years, the last 3 years, I put something bigger in every 3 or 4 months.
That's right, it's time for E! News Daily, and all today's important stories covered in one neat little half hour. Well, it'll be pretty neat. We dusted today.